the last session, second last session rather, for the day, sports administration and fitness. And I have a beautiful panel of veterans with me. I also have a wonderful moderator who would always want to share his experience and knowledge. I have with me as the moderator, Mr. Ramji Srinivasan, founder MD Sports Dynamic SNC Indian Cricket. Welcome, sir.
Hi. Thank you. Thank you for the invite. Nice to be here once more. Thank
Pleasure's
you so much.
Pleasure, sir. Let me give you a brief into Mr. Ramji Srinivasan's life. He is a high-performance coach and also the founder director of Sports Dynamics. He has the strength and conditioning as he was the coach of 2011 World Cup winning Indian cricket team. He's also the leading coach in India. He comes with a huge experience and success rate in the field of sports and fitness. To his credit, he has amazing titles. I will list a few for everyone's knowledge and reference. First Indian coach for the Indian cricket team for 4 years. First Indian coach to be the part of the World Cup winning team, Champions Trophy and Champions League games. First Indian coach to train Formula One driver Naren Karthikeyan. First Indian coach for A1GP Formula Racing India. First Indian coach for Indian rally teams. He has also been invited by USTA to organize fitness camp in USA. For Asian Americans. He has also been a coach for MRF Pace Foundation for 13 years, coach for Mumbai Indian for 4 years, consultant CSK past 2 years. He is also the coach for Krishnan Tennis Center for the last 4 years. He has also been the coach for JK Racing Team for 2 years. And for the last but not the least, Tamil Nadu Ranji Team and Tamil Nadu Cricket Academy. He holds it strong being a coach. I also have a beautiful set of panelists with me, with industry professionals. I have Mr. Rishikesh Joshi. Welcome, sir.
Yeah, hi.
Sports for All. Then I have with me institution professional, Mr. Nilesh Kulkarni, former Indian cricketer, founder, director, International Institute of Sports Management, and also a TEDx speaker. Welcome, sir. I also have in youth professionals with me, Mr. Rakesh Raghavan, football coach for Bhaichung Bhutia Football Schools. Welcome, Rakesh. And
hi,
I have a student with me, the youth student, Mr. Tanmay Darshan from Dayanand University. Welcome on. Over to you, Mr. Ramji Srinivasan.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Welcome all. Nice to be back again. And I would like to introduce one by one. It's a huge list, which I'll take a whole day reading about their accolades and achievements. I'll keep it as short as possible for the benefit of the viewers and spend more time on their experience and knowledge and sharing what they've been, their journey, basically. First is Mr. Rishikesh Joshi. He's an experienced founder with demonstrated history of working in sports industry, skilled in business development, marketing strategy, sponsorship, sports and sports marketing. Strong business development professional with masters in sports management, focused on sports management, information technology from Erythuan University, Australia. And he also had an intern sessions with Mumbai Indians for 3-4 years when Mumbai Indians won their first IPL title. And very hardworking, very enterprising young gentleman. Now we shift on to the next legend in the panel, Mr. Nilesh Kulkarni. He's got a massive, reading his accolades will be like reading his horoscope. So pretty short though. And he doesn't need any introduction. Former India cricket player, spinner, played for Mumbai, won the Ranji Trophy for quite a number of times. And he has got a rare distinction of taking and first Indian to take a wicket in his first ball in Test cricket, which is really an amazing achievement. And he played for 17 years and 4 years for India. Also, post his retirement, he walked the talk literally how he carried on with his on-field experience and to become a sports Edupruna, founder director of International Institute of Sports Management based out of Mumbai, which is one of its kind in the country for professionals embarking on sports management courses and sports related courses. And he has published loads and loads of paper on various subjects, and he has helped loads of youngsters graduating from his college, finding a good foothold in their respective fields. And I'm keeping it very short though, this one, and I can go on and on for some more time. Next one, Mr. Rakesh is a fitness fanatic, I can say, and passionate about his fitness and passionate about his soccer. He's working in Tesco, and his passion led him to take up soccer in a big way, and a highly qualified coach who's got a D certification program from Soccer Academy. The next one is Mr. Tanmay. Tanmay is like a, what do you call, I would say like a Forrest Gump man. He's a marathon man, keep running his marathon, very passionate about his running. And he's an engineering student, passion for long distance running and multi-sport. And he was one of the youngest to complete the Pro Camp Slam running of in 2018-19. He competed in and completed in four marathons. That is, one is in TCS in marathon in Bangalore, Airtel half marathon in Delhi, Tata Steel Kolkata 25k marathon, and then Tata Mumbai marathon, full marathon. He also got a rare distinction, Indian Book of Records, of three generations of his father, his grandfather, and himself competing and running the marathons together, which is a rare phenomena. And he is also part of a marathon running group called Jainagar Jaguars. So I think my throat is slightly sore now, talking about their accolades and much more to come. And welcome, gentlemen. It's great to have you all, and right up our forte, sports and sports-related topic. And viewers, these four people have proven in their respective fields and respective associations or their specific skills, and they walk the talk, basically embarking on a new territory successfully and efficiently and paving a way for a new generation of youngsters. And let's pick their brain up one by one, and I'll have 4 or 5 questions to start off with. I think it can take a little bit more time or less time, then we can go in for question and answer session from the audience. Okay, let's come to the first question I would like to ask is, now we are in a COVID state, you know, all under house arrest, and can you hear, Rishi?
Can we hear Ramji? Sorry.
Yeah, I can hear you. You're okay, Rishi?
Now I'm okay. Yeah, now I'm okay. I don't know. I lost you for a second. Sorry.
No problem. I'm very fully here. So now we are in a very crazy situation of COVID. Whole world is shut. Everything is shut. Sports, of course, got hammered very badly in many fronts. What do you, from your respective angles, I will come one by one, from your respective angles, what paradigm shift post-COVID is expected? Okay, what is the paradigm shift, what we expect to have post-COVID? What are the challenges which may face post-COVID? As far as education is concerned, I'll directly come to Nilesh, who is running a very successful academy for sports management. what challenge you would face post COVID, and how do you plan to tackle it?
Okay, first of all, thank you for the invite. It's a wonderful panel to be on. And thank you, Ramji, for this elaborative, wonderful introduction.
And I kept it very short.
And I'm part of two records, one in my favor, one against India.
Absolutely.
952 runs, that's still the record. So, in the same test match.
Brilliant. Sorry, I missed that out.
But on a note where you're saying, I personally feel the new normal needs to be accepted, embraced, planned upon, worked upon, to try and find a solution. Because from coming from a sports background, you know, you encounter a lot of challenges in your life. But you know, if you get stuck on the problems, you don't think about the problem solving situations. And this situation has offered us an opportunity to think differently. It has offered us an opportunity to see where the opportunities are and then start planning. So one of the key areas where we have decided to not experiment, but you know, go ahead with, is a combination of planning a digital and physical teaching during the COVID period. Because, you know, as we all know, sport cannot be taught digitally, because the passion with which faculties teach, the experience for students from a practical component as well as the real-time experiences cannot be achieved digitally. So what we have done, we have broken it into three different segments. One is the digital delivery, which will happen from a classroom to a student perspective, the way we are having right now. The second component of that digital is the breakout part of keeping them into group and getting them up to the group, doing a lot of internships and research work by being at home. So which allows them to upgrade, which allows them to understand what is expected. So the it could be an interaction with faculty, it could be an interaction with Rushi's Sports for All, or taking a research topic. This will allow students to work upon something and create a document which will be submitted to them for the assessment as well. And the third most important part is to give them a real-time practical perspective when the lockdown is lifted, for them to understand what they've learned in a class and what they've worked upon on their research or the internship during their internship part, get practically experienced. So we have broken that into three segments of this so that they don't miss out and lose out. The technical challenge which we face because of the guidelines and the university UGC guidelines, we cannot push the academic part into the next semester.
So
we are facing our technical challenge to complete the modules. If unfortunately the lockdown continues for a longer period, we still have to work around finding a ways to this particular component. But at the moment, we have loaded most of our practical exposure and experience part for students into the second semester so that the theory gets completed into first and they're ready to get into the industry when the lockdown is fully normalized from a new normal perspective with the sports ecosystem opening up.
Oh, brilliant, brilliant. That's very, very, very systematically planned, Nilesh. Always like you're bowling.
One of the reasons, Ramji, the challenge what we face is the student's future is our responsibility.
Yes.
And if we don't plan for their future, we are not doing a justice to what they trust in us as an institute. So, we did about a month and a half of a piloting with multiple platforms going back and forth to come out with what we feel will be a right extraction for students, and hence these three paths what we've designed.
Oh, brilliant, 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 brilliant. That is a very important message in this is there is always a new shift. There is always a new pathway to go, experience and walk through, you know, which you find a solution to at the end of the tunnel. Okay, coming back to the same question, Rishi. Rishi, you've been running a very, very successful and one of its kind of sports outdoor activity in the country, and with huge number of students involved in the Sports for All, you know, which is very, very commendable and very difficult to manage as far as the sports management, which you are professional in it. And what are the difficulties because you are supposed to have your programs now during the summer, you know, setting up off-season programs and then progressing from there over a period of time. And you have a system in place, system process and protocols in place. And how have you tweaked it now to get to the next level?
Correct.
Would you please share your thoughts?
Firstly, thank you so much for the opportunity, Ramji and Skillablers. Amazing to be on a platform like this, which I understand is looking at all industries and not just sports. So, you know, we've always been fighting for having sport, having that industry status. And I think this is the first step of us being recognized as a mainstream industry with Skillablers having us on board. So thank you so much.
To be cutting in the middle slightly, you are an industry by yourself and Nilesh is an industry by himself.
Yeah. We're all a part of one industry. In fact, without Nilesh, we can't do anything.
Then a new ecosystem in place, you know, which is very, very important for India. You know?
Yeah.
Please
go
ahead.
Correct. So, I'll kind of take you through this journey ever since we started off with SFA, because before that I had this wonderful opportunity, you know, of working with Mumbai Indians, or even before that, you know, getting exposed to a lot of, you know, business people, a lot of forums, even before I started doing SFA. And the one thing that I heard way back, you know, even in so we started SFA in 2015. But around 2013-14, you know, when we were firming up the plans of how to go about doing it, you know, we were very clear in the start in 2014-15 that we are not purely going to be an on-ground business. Okay. We are going to be, you know, a combination of on-ground and online. So, and that's why we kind of, you know, in the decks, if I pull back our decks of 2015-16, we have used the word phygital, P-H-Y-G-I-T-A-L.
Oh, physical and digital.
Yes, we've used that in our initial decks in 2015-16, you know, and I think somewhere down the line those words got lost, and here we are again with us labeling ourselves with as a digital company. We had a little bit of an exposure on the online scheme of things, and because what COVID has done is forced businesses to come online. I wouldn't say that, you know, it was never in our plan. It was in our plan. The plan has been accelerated, but the challenges are completely different, right? I mean, what it took us about four and a half, five years to establish ourselves on ground, you know, we encountered new challenges as we moved ahead. We scaled up to new cities, you know, we kind of expanded in different verticals, so to speak. And that is when we experienced, you know, new challenges. And just about at the time when our on-ground, we thought that, you know, we've kind of got our bearings right finally after 4 or 5 years, is when COVID struck us. And so, you know, all the plans that obviously that we had from April to October this year, which were largely on-ground, and the digitization of stuff was going to happen in the background, we didn't obviously have the luxury of doing that. But the online process really accelerated for us. In fact, you know, we keep asking ourselves this question that what do we do online with sport? What do we do online with sport? You know, how much of it can be, as Nilesh Bhai said, that if you cannot feel the environment, feel the proposition, feel the energy, then that's the crux, you know, that's that pivot on which the entire sport kind of rests, right? I mean, we've always spoken about the fact that if Federer and Nadal may play, but if nobody's going to watch, it just doesn't make sense. So that is the whole center point of sport is people, right? It's people.
Yes,
and
absolutely.
And with people now not being able to come together, with us, obviously, you know, we work with a lot of kids and schools and all of that predominantly. So the reservations are there. So now what we are trying to do is trying to deliver programs online so that people can, you know, train, learn, educate themselves in a particular sport or in a particular skill through our new platform, which is sfaplay.com. Ramji, I think you're aware of it.
Yes.
But what we have found in this process, right? I mean, so if, for example, also, so it's a sort of an aggregation, so to speak. But when you, you know, already present on ground, you have that little bit of an edge because people already know you. It's not that, oh, this is a new company that's come out of nowhere. They already know what you do on ground. And thereby that traction is much better. But the service providers, right? I mean, be it the academies, coaches, the product itself is
is something that takes a little longer because your people have academies, coaches, you know, all of them who've been training on ground. I'm sure Rakesh will be able to throw some light on that as well. But it takes a lot of, it took a lot of effort from them also for us to be able to bring a product online, right?
Absolutely.
And at the same time, I think where we were with digital, right? For example, 15 years back, we were not confident ourselves of making an online payment through a credit card or anything of that sort. Because that's how far back, you know, digital India was. And you see where it has come in the last about 10 years, so to speak.
Yes,
and,
absolutely.
I think with sport, I think the world has changed forever. It's not that the same normal will come back. There is going to be a new normal, as Nilesh Bhai said. And that will be a combination of, you know, online and on ground is what we anticipate it to be. So thereby we are, you know, trying to see as many more people that we can provide in sport, provide livelihoods to as well, right? By helping them come up with online products and things like that. And the amazing part of it is, you know, we've been able to go to multiple corners of India where there are, you know, small people in very, very remote locations, but have this amazing skill. So we have been able to, in fact, you know, try and work with some of those. And also the language barriers that we face is the second thing that we anticipate, because the minute you are a digital business, you have to be able to deliver to more than your territory. So yeah, interesting times, but early days. There is no doubt in my mind that a fine balance of digital and physical, even in sport, is the new normal going forward. So, I mean, we are also trying a lot of new stuff as we experiment, and let's see, you know, how successful we can be with that. But absolutely. Yeah, everybody's support will matter.
So, yeah. Absolutely. Fantastic. Fantastic journey so far, Rishi. I think... from your system, there are loads and loads of people, professionals percolating from Nilesh's system into your system. And there is phenomenal traction, so that there you marry a practical and theoretical aspect of it, which brings success over a period of time.
Right.
Couldn't have happened 5 years back or 7 years back or 10 years back. No, we keep talking.
Yeah.
And this is a real practical application coming into play now. It's fantastic, journey.
Yeah, I think the timing of our businesses are also, you know, we're just about starting to align because, you know, the time that it takes to build, like I remember having a conversation with Nilesh Bhai in Guwahati at the Khelo India Games, where he mentioned that, you know, what people see today is what they see today, but it has taken us 10 years to be where we are today. Nobody actually sees that. And I think right now also I'm feeling... you know, the goosebumps, because what goes behind really matters. And absolutely. I think that builds the foundation of anything that we do.
So. Absolutely. And the thing is, we always see the end product, how successful individual is or how successful an organization is, and what nobody sees the sacrifices and the hard work and putting a head down and working hard. Nobody sees that, whether it's a business or a sports person. Yes, Nilesh.
I'll just add one more thing. You know, this part of what the tip of the iceberg, what we see, or you know, the success part, so to speak, comes with a lot of failure perspectives, which teaches you how to handle different situations differently.
Okay.
And that's where I personally feel sport gave us an edge to analyze, understand, and start applying it. You know, because I personally feel a lot of people look at it failure as a negative aspect. I look at it failure
as positive. Positive, absolutely.
Because failure teaches you how to handle it, how to overcome it, and how to challenge yourself to not make the same mistake again.
Yeah.
So for me, those learnings of my cricketing journey, I've learned to apply that into my workplace.
Absolutely.
And fortunately, that has given us good establishment. And then things have been worked out better.
Failure somehow is just a taboo word in India. It shouldn't be. It is positive experiences, honestly. As long as you don't make the same mistake twice.
I'll just add one point before you go on to others, Ramji.
Coming back to the point, please go ahead.
So, I mean, I'm sure all our kids and parents who are listening to this, they must be knowing our Honorable Ex-Prime Minister, President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He beautifully defined the word fail into positive. He has elaborated that as first attempt in learning. How he described
absolutely.
Failure.
Amazing.
Absolutely, absolutely. You slightly stole my thunder as far as votes are concerned. As far as I was about to come to that, you know, two people we were talking about failure. I'm coming to you, Rakesh. Just you know, after this quote, I'm coming back to you because you have loads of things to answer to. That is, like Einstein said, you know, anyone who has never made a mistake has never tried anything new. You know, that is one of Einstein's quotes. You know, second one is our own legend, Chanakya. You know, he has said once, learn from the mistake of others. You cannot live long enough to make them all yourself.
Yeah, true. So,
everything true. Is a learning curve. And I was slightly afraid that Nilesh stole my thunder, but he kept to a different angle and different perspective.
Yeah. No, I mean, these quotes, they just take, you know, they take like 2 seconds to talk. But, you know, it's an experience of a lifetime that actually makes you realize these four words, you know. And I mean, at different stages of your journey, you start realizing each one of them in different ways. It's
absolutely
fantastic.
Absolutely. Yeah. That is literally walk the talk.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, absolutely.
Now, shifting from one sports management expert to an educationist, now coming on to a coach and fitness trainer, strength and conditioning point of view. Okay, this post-COVID, currently everybody is going through a tough times. And what do you feel from a coach's perspective? You're an accredited soccer coach and a strength and conditioning coach. What do you feel is going to change now? How things are going to change as far as the preparation is concerned? What are the problems and prospects in this lockdown?
Well, as Nilesh Bhav already said that, you know, that COVID, this is the new normal. We have to face that and believe that and take this is a new normal. We have to start believing in that now. Because if we keep a lot of negativity spread across because of this. So how we change this into positive is believing that this is a new normal. I know what the precautions that I need to take. And not staying negative or not staying depressed. And again, as Nilesh Bhav already mentioned, I think nothing like sports. The best thing to, you know, teach you as how to accept failure. Sports is the best thing. Because in sports, there are two teams and only one team wins the game. But every team learns a lot from the others. So nothing like that. So there is always, sports teaches you that how to accept defeat and how to overcome it also. So that's in that way, that's the best thing is sports. That's the reason I love sports so much because
keeps you grounded, isn't it? Completely grounded.
Absolutely. Than any other thing. Even if you go to a reality show of the year, music or there, you get depressed. I see kids being depressed in those shows. They're not able to accept failures. But in sports, they are fine with it. They know they have another chance. Tomorrow I have another game. I can beat this. I can learn something new and I can come back and beat this team, you know, whatever it is. Absolutely. You always see positives from the negatives in sports. That's the best thing about sports.
Absolutely.
And it's, sports is completely passion driven. You have to have the passion that, yes, I need this. You have to dive into it. I mean, as everyone's saying, as Rishikesh ji and even Nilesh said, I mean, what we had 10 years, 15 years back, the opportunities and the exposure, what you have now is way too much.
Absolutely. It's a new shift as far as it is
the platform what you have.
I would say.
Absolutely. I mean, the platform what you have now, I mean, even as sir, you're an expert in SNC, SNCs. Even SNC, you know how much we have to go to the centers and then do your exercises. It is available digitally now. They're doing it live sessions. So it's not that, I mean, yes, COVID, everyone would love to go out and do these things, but you don't have to hold yourself back. You can still continue doing it from home now.
Absolutely.
It's your mental strength, you know, how you keep yourself mentally strong. Yes, if not this, there is this. You have to find your options if you want that. So like me, I love working outside, but now I know I can't go out much. I'm doing my workouts at home.
Absolutely.
So that is very important. And yes, and as far as football and coaching, all this is concerned, So we know where India lies as far as football is concerned. So we are doing great nowadays.
I think Indian soccer
big time
coming in. I think it's
absolutely
given a huge
that was
to soccer.
That was very much needed because we are so used to watching the other leagues and all that. We
always,
always wanted something in India too. Yes.
Of, game.
Because I watch all sports. Let it be NBA, football, your athletics, tennis. I watch everything. I keep a track of all sports.
Wow.
So I used to play cricket a lot in my school days for regional, subzonal, zonal level and all. But of course, then football also was there. And I think it's just that passion which needs to end. We have to look at the grassroots level if you're looking at something big to achieve for India. Probably not now. It might take a few years, might take 10 years also. But if you start identifying from the grassroots level, the football, the main coaching, this thing for us was, you know, to look at the grassroots level first. If we can bring somebody from there. Because I can't go ahead and fine-tune somebody's skill now at who's already 20, who's already playing.
Very true. There, I like to,
I need to
add on a codicil to your thing, finding a grassroots level. In India, the problem, practical problem is we go to the root or graze the tip of a grass, you know, either this way or that way. There is no system in place. Because I'm not trying to pass accolades on superlatives on Nilesh and Rishi. Because they walk the talk. Trust me on this. Because being in this field for more than 20 years, we haven't found, I never found any certification courses or anything related to sport, anything related to talent identification and the process and protocols in place, which has come in last 5 years to 10 years time. So I think from my angle, what I look at them is, they are one of the key people, those who are setting up the process and protocols in the country, you know, which is, different ball game altogether. There is also a nice saying, I think, doing things in indoor, as you said, trying to adapt and adopt is a key, you know, very
absolutely
important.
Sir.
Efficient warrior, even a blade of grass is a weapon, you know. So, like a ninja, you know, he can kill you with a blade of grass.
In fact, Ramji, I have a beautiful saying of a lot of my sports friends share that with me.
Yeah.
You win and you learn. You don't lose.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Keep your mindset into a positive frame of yours. You should always think about either you win or you learn.
Absolutely. You're spot on. Exactly. And people don't see that. You know, the problem is people don't see that win or lose only two angles, black or white. It is not. You know, there is something in the middle path which is really colorful, you know, which you can, you know, nobody is willing to see that.
Yeah.
Either they are colorblind or myopic in their vision, you know?
That's what, right? I mean, that's the whole thing with, say, artificial intelligence or robotics, right? They say that what you will learn in 30 years as a human being, that robot will learn in 30 seconds, probably. What took you 30 years to learn? But the problem is that middle path that we experience, probably robots or the artificial intelligence
absolutely
will never be able to kind of get there. So
absolutely.
Experience is everything. Yeah.
Absolutely. Very true. Very true. Through experience, there are so many facets to it which you can learn. Loads and loads of things which you can learn through experience, whether
it's bad or
ugly. You know?
Yeah, in fact, I also did sports management, right, from Australia almost 16, 17 years ago. But that one piece that was missing, which I see with IISM and, you know, the students, is that the amount of exposure on ground experiences and exposure that, you know, IISM is being able to provide to its kids is fantastic. And another thing, I mean, obviously to that is that, say, 15 years back when, 16 years back when I joined the industry, there were hardly one or two companies doing sport. So where was there any opportunity any which way, right?
Absolutely.
But now, and that's where what I meant by timing, that now once so many good and the quality of IISM students, right? I've been at least seeing it personally over the last 5 years and has really improved. And at the same time, the opportunities for these students have also come together. So I think some very, very exciting times for sports professionals, sports businesses and sport in general, right? And you know, as Rakesh mentioned, that sport is all about passion. I like, there is no, because if we didn't have passion, I think none of us would have been here. But I also think that another ingredient which I would really like to inculcate in, you know, the likes of Tanmay and all today is persistence. Because passion, you know, in sports is, yes, it takes you thus far. But after that, you know, you have to persist when you are, when you face the challenges, when you face the, you know, the hardships.
Perseverance is the key.
Perseverance and passion together will really, you know, is that key ingredient that you need in any sphere.
Passion leads to performance. Three P's.
Yeah, yes, we've got a new quote for Ramji. But yeah, that's that. No, but I really mean everything that I say. Yeah.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. Superb, superb. Now coming to Tanmay. Okay, now you are a marathon runner. You are an outdoor person. You know, you cannot be tied inside the house. You are like Tom Hanks and Forrest Gump. Keep running. You grow your beard. So how do you manage? What do you do? What do you do? You know, what is your mindset? You know? Because it's very important to understand the mindset of a sportsman and how you are able to apply and mold yourself like an octopus into the system. You know, how did you do it? What is your take on that?
Okay, so when I've been a marathon runner and a long distance runner for about 6 years now. My dad got me into this sport, and fortunately, my granddad is also into running, and all three of us have got into the India Book of Records right now.
Yeah.
That was a recent
achievement. Fantastic achievement.
Thank you. So for us, yes, it was only outdoor running, and running on treadmills was never an, even we didn't even consider it. So when the lockdown happened and this COVID situation came by, it was quite tough for us because we were not prepared for it, and we didn't have a treadmill at home because it was too spontaneous for it and we couldn't decide on that. So we just started building up on our muscles, and then we thought, okay, let's, if not endurance, let's just build up on the strength of each muscle. So we started on building strength in each muscle. So that's how I took up into it. And once the lockdown was open, yes, there's no...
I think tiger let out of the cage.
Oh, yes, definitely.
You know, yes. I can understand that. But mostly it's more, it becomes more psychological than physiological, because physiologically you can do something. Psychologically, you know, you have to adapt. You know, very important is to kill. That
yes.
Boredom can set in. And more can you can set in, you know, that can lead a decrement in your performance.
Decrement, yes.
Even your day-to-day activity.
Yes, super, and super. Main thing was motivation there, because most of us weren't motivated enough to get up and do something at home itself. So that motivation was required, and yes, for me, motivation is right at my house. So.
Yes. Yeah, you have two stalwarts in your house to motivate you, otherwise you'll get hammered.
Yes.
You cannot run anywhere. Actually, they'll chase you down like Mossad intelligence. You know,
yes.
You're part of the world URL, they'll chase you down.
Yes.
So, coming back to the next point, I would start off with Nilesh again. Prospect of a sports person taking up a career in their respective fields, because today morning I spoke about it. In brief, thing, either through post-retirement or we are talking about passion, you know, what passion and their aptitude and their personality types. How does it seem? How does it pan out in the future? Look at 5 years, 10 years down the line. And what is your take on it? How do you plan to upgrade?
So, okay, I'll just give you two scenarios in this. What happens is that sports people always have a very good attitude.
Yes.
And many a times the missing link is the aptitude, purely because of the academic orientation and a background. So what we at IISM try and do is we want them to have a balanced approach of an attitude and an aptitude. So we have put a lot of filters for getting our students cleared. The reason for that is, you know, if you need to be industry ready, if you need to understand what the market requires. See, you may have a good passion. You may have a good attitude of going and handling that situation. But your aptitude level also needs to raise up to start having the expectation match. Because if tomorrow, for example, I'm working for Rishi and there is a critical thinking situation and a problem solving challenge, if I am not oriented myself and equip myself from a technical knowledge, I may have a very good attitude, but if I don't have an orientation from an academic background or a situational background, I will always lag behind in coming up with the right solution. And in sports, in many situations, you want those leaders, and that leadership needs to start taking responsibility, accountability for the decision, whether it's a right or a wrong decision, the ideal situation, because as I said before, you may fail, but at least you have attempted to do something. That itself, as the owner of the company or the senior person in charge of that, will always look that he or she made an attempt. It did not go the way they wanted it, but at least the attempt and the effort was there. In this situation, this is very critical for a lot of aspiring students who want to make a career in sport, because in sport, it's real time. It's black and white. Yep. You know, if, for example, Rushi has a contract of Khelo India opening ceremony. If 1% goes wrong, the entire act or the decision goes haywire. No, yeah. Who's accountable? Rushi's neck is accountable for it.
Correct.
And who's responsible? You are responsible for making sure that part is done right. So these are the processes which you require to have an orientation, knowledge, and experience. Because like I was listening to the conversation also, one thing I want to address to all the listeners here, one thing you cannot buy in the market, and that is experience.
Absolutely.
You have to gain it by stalking yourself and making sure you overcome by getting the right path. Because what works for me may not work for you. And what works for you may not work for Rishi. Everybody is different of handling, understanding, and delivering that. So what is important is self-assessment, analyzing that, and making sure that you make that right choice when with your gut feeling of your experiences helps you understand. And for me, this particular quality, Ramji, will define the future of sport in India, because we will require not only the athletes who will represent India, but the sports personalities who will bring this difference in the industry, give us that edge of achieving excellence in years to come. And if India, as per our Honorable Prime Minister and the Sports Minister, they aspire to make this as a sporting country.
Absolutely.
You guys are the future who will bring in that change in the industry. And this could be across all spectrums.
Spectrums.
Do not limit only from management. It could be science. It could be nutrition. It could be, event management, technology, across all verticals. Engineering.
Yeah.
So you talk about it, you will create your own space if you have a passion to make a career in sport. And for me, that's the most exciting part I see in next 10 years unfolding, Ramji. Because if the movement has taken start, I see the pace with which we will increase that in next 5 to 10 years is phenomenal.
Yeah.
I will just give you one small comparative analysis.
Yes.
In form of IPL, the digital media rights of IPL 3.5 years back went for almost 0 rupees. And in the last bid, the digital media rights went for 3,700 crores for 5 years. So the shift of the curve was very steep, you know, when from nowhere to straight away a steep advantage. So for me, that's the most exciting part to see in next 5 to 10 years, how the industry shapes, grows, and establishes.
Absolutely, absolutely. Fantastically, very well said, Nilesh. I think the support system, not only an athlete coming and bringing laurels to a country, what goes behind the support system from a sports management, from a sports trainers to et cetera, the entire support system is very key to build a fantastic ecosystem for the growth. Absolutely, very well said.
Just to add one number crunching part, for one IPL event in India, there are 23 to 25,000 people work behind the scenes to make IPL a success. For one Khelo India event, there are 6,500 plus people with the help of people like Rushi who make sure that the event is delivered successfully. That's the scale of an opportunity you guys are looking for.
Absolutely. I'm sure the people, those who are hearing this, it's like a big tonic for them as far as sports industry is concerned, and what career you need to embark on the sports field. Two experts and two upcoming experts are also there. And you know, as far as other thing, Rishi, which I would like to ask you is, what entails for you? You organize some phenomenally big events like Hello India and SFA, which is like a mini Olympics, you know, which is second to none in spot on organizing things to the T, you know, very professionally. What it entails basically, who are the basically support system, your verticals? We are talking about the sports management to people related to sport. Who are all the people which would be involved in that? Whether that can be strength and conditioning experts or coaches, etc., etc.
So, correct. So, if I take up, you know, talk about specifically multi-sport platforms, which you spoke about, which is like a Khelo India or an SFA or, you know, what the Olympics or the Commonwealth Games or any of these are, right? Which are multi-sport platforms, right? And I have had this amazing experience of working, as Nilesh Bhai said, you know, so many number of professionals work in the IPL. So for 9 years, I've been working in the IPL as well. And what I see, in fact, and before that, I worked for the marathons. In fact, I worked for ProCam International for 3 years, even before I. So I've kind of experienced, you know, different range of events at different scale. Obviously, all are pretty large, but with different different dynamics, right? Each of these events have completely, like an IPL is very different dynamics from a Khelo India to a marathon, which marathon is probably a one-day event. So, you know, the dynamics of that are completely different. But ultimately, what it needs, right? It needs people's processes, systems, and detailing, right? These are the four pillars on which anything can be managed systematically and optimally, right? I mean, I have seen times where, you know, because sport has grown really, literally over the last 8-10 years, it has really grown. So when I started off, I've also seen times where, you know, a job, if it could be done by one person, there were actually 10 people deployed for that one job only, just because there were no systems in place. So they had a plan B, plan C, plan D, plan E, and that, because are ye nahi aayega, isko bimar ho jayega, isko kuch. So that's how things were planned at that point in time, because you know, it was new for everybody. And the optimization that systems, processes, and technology has brought in over the last few years, I think, has completely transformed the delivery of putting all of these things up together. And the backbone of any sports event till date, I feel, is, you know, it's the volunteers, it's the people on the ground. I mean, I remember when I went to give my first interview at Mumbai Indians, how many ever years back that was, maybe 2008 or 2009, is when one thing, you know, the gentleman who was taking my interview, Ashish Bhai, Ashish Kumar Chauhan, he told me that, you know, he just told me one thing, that the man in sport is king. The guy who knows how to clean the grass is always going to be the king in sport, because you cannot start off a career in sport sitting out of a plush office, not knowing what it takes to get a job done. Absolutely. Right. So, and that's when he told me that you choose, what do you want to do? You know, do you want to do cricket development, team management, logistics, etc., or do you want to straight get into marketing and sponsorships? Because I had done my, you know, master's in sports management. Before that, I had some experience. So I told him, what is the difference between the two, you know? He's like, he told me clearly that either marketing sponsorships mein tu paisa seekh jayega, either tu actually sport aur kaam karna seekh jayega. And I chose that path, which probably would have been much longer a journey. But if I would not have undertaken that journey, I don't think I would have ever been able to sell a sponsorship if I did not know, you know, how many kilos the bag of a cricketer weighs, right? If you did not realize all of that, if you did not learn it with your experiences over a period of time, ultimately, you know, you are not going to be able to make it. So that's something that I tell, you know, even my team and my organization, saying that with sport, if you have to ultimately lead anything, you have to be able to experience the different verticals. Right, absolutely. What it takes. I mean, you need to know what it takes to organize a training session. Also, you know what you need to know what it takes to plan logistics. You need to know what it takes to manage crowds. You need to, and ultimately, you can
comprehensive outlook on everything. You know, complete from nuts bolts to high-end, high-tech artificial intelligence.
Yes, and the difference between sport and any other business, you know, I mean, accounting, finance, retail, whatever you call it, it's still got the same fundamentals, right? You still have accounting, taxation, finance, etc., etc. But the difference when it comes to sports management is really, you know, the human interaction, the people, it's people management more than anything else. If you can manage people well, because you need to know you are dealing with an athlete, you're not dealing just with a business person.
Business person.
So, and that has got sentiments, that has got emotions, that has got a lot of things involved before you can make that one statement to an athlete. So I think that's pretty much the difference, but that core ingredient is still people and processes, so to speak.
Absolutely. It's completely. Yeah. Very well said, Rishi. I think we are pressed for time now. Time flies here. I have two questions here. I think first question, what are the specialized courses and professional education for sports admin and fitness? I think who can answer this? And Nilesh or Rakesh or Tanmay? Anybody? We can keep it short because we have 2-3 more questions. Maybe Nilesh?
I'm happy that there are institutes and universities, even Government of India now officially announced a sports university plan, which will start enrolling students from next academic year.
Fantastic.
So from a physical fitness aspect, the BPED part, the coaching aspects, which are the standard formal educational structures. There is one university in Chennai, also, which offers that. But if you want a experience with the different dimensions, with the practical perspectives and approach from management to others, there are institutes like what we try and give as an experience to student is more on the combination of theory and practical, because it makes you better as a professional. It makes you understand the requirements from theory and then learn to apply that into practical.
Practical.
I think that is very critical for your journey, because you know, if you start having only the theory part, and once you start applying it to Ruchi's place, you will get exposed, because the practical perspective is equally and more important.
Absolutely.
Than the theory. Absolutely. And likewise, even Ramji will probably kick my back if I send the students without having a good qualification, because the expectations in the market are different.
Yes.
Because
Absolutely.
It's dynamic. You know, you need to be ready with handling those situations. You need to be ready with critical thinking cap of yours to understand and then come up with the problem solving challenges. So these are the areas we empower our students to come with. We orient our students to get ready with. And that's when we get less complaints from organizations like SFAs, DNA.
I think they're only compliments, right?
It's a compliment.
Oh yeah, you bet.
If we get less complaints, because otherwise earlier part of our journey, we started getting those complaints and we overcame that. Like I said before, we made mistakes and we learned from it. So one of the areas which we feel now is that combination, which is extremely critical for student as a good journey in sports.
Whether it's students, whether it's a management or a fitness course, there are loads and loads of opportunities available in our country itself, because end of the day, what Nilesh said, Rishi and Tanmay and Rakesh, they all, I'm sure they'll all agree upon certain things, is where theory meets practice, there lies performance. We can talk theory for hours together without getting into practical aspect of it, which is not going to help anywhere. You can take classes inside the classroom and keep quiet. But when your sport is not like that, it's not done inside the between four walls. So it has to be transferable. The moment your knowledge is not able to, you're not able to transfer the knowledge and critical thinking, quicksilver thinking and application, it is not going to help you in any way. Passion is one thing. The application of passion, and be practical about it, what passion is all about, combining with aptitude, combining with individual, personality type, also matters quite a lot. Whether you are a management person or a non-field person, whether you are an indoor or outdoor person, whether you are an extrovert or introvert. You know, it all depends on your personality types also, you can be successful at. You need to understand those things when you are embarking on this sort of journey.
Right.
The number last question for today. How is technology shaping the world of sports and fitness? What are the startup opportunities to look forward to? I think, Tanmay, you can answer. You are an engineering student. Just quick answer, maybe a couple of lines.
Yes. Can you just repeat the question? I had some issues in hearing.
How is technology shaping the world of sport and fitness? What are the startup opportunities?
Okay.
You can answer the first part of the question. Second, I'll come to these two gentlemen.
Experience. Yes, sure. Okay. So now, it's all, since because of this pandemic, everything has become digitalized and many people are looking forward for online sessions and online seminars as well. To where, suppose Pult, for example, they're doing a brilliant job in that. So they have sessions throughout the day which go, and people like me are also very interested. And it's not that you have to attend every session, but whichever you're interested in, just log into it and get on with it. So,
Thank you. That's quick and succinct. Rakesh, your view on that. How technology is shaping up sports and fitness, since you are a coach.
Absolutely. And absolutely, as I said to you earlier, it's just what others put across. It's about your interest. And of course, there are many things which are coming online these days. You just have to spend half an hour a day is more than enough. If you can put in half an hour of your daily time, just put half an hour rigorously and seriously. That's it. You'll reach, you'll get your results. You'll see the results in that.
Nice. How is technology helping? Nice. I mean, what sort of platforms you use, or how do you feel? Is it helping, or you feel that as a coach, you feel you're going to plateau at some point of time? It's going to plateau off.
No, it's helping, because again, the parents are encouraging the students, their kids. They're encouraging the kids. That's the most important thing. Again, what we need is the parents have to encourage the kids to get into this. And they're also encouraging the online coaching also. I know it's not the same as what you do outside in the ground, but of course, something's better than nothing, you know, than doing nothing. You can at least do this. They're still in that touch with the touch. They don't lose the touch of what they've been doing all this while. Absolutely. So technology is helping.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Very well said. Very well said. The thing is, again, one more before I jump to the second part of the question to you, gentlemen. Very important from my point of view as being a strength and conditioning coach is transferables. How you are able to transfer what you learn indoor to outdoor. Very, very, very critical period for sports people, because this is when it's potentially a dangerous trend to get injured. You know, too fast, too soon. Ideas, the transformation, whether it's positive transfer or a negative transfer or a neutral transfer, is very, very important. You know, you have to plan the sports people have to plan their scheduling accordingly.
Can I just add to the thoughts of what the question has been asked also?
Please.
Technology is helping a lot in terms of data collection, data analysis. The most important part, it cuts across all the sectors. So for what you see on television as the presenter or the expert, there is a feedback mechanism with real-time generation of information.
Reports.
For example, now if Rushi is doing a Khelo India event, the technology has helped his organization understand the challenges they faced in their last deliverables to better it from the next deliverables. There's always an advantage. I'll just give you a feedback system. I'll just give you one important piece of information for all the viewers and the question which is asked. The classic example of Virat Kohli, how he has become fit. The technology helped him understand the strength, the weaknesses, and the opportunities which can get him better and consistent.
Absolutely.
I played that to when we started playing cricket. McDonald's burger, if we eat, there was nobody to ask a question. But when Ramji came, he would snatch a burger from a hand because the importance of fitness with the real-time data, which made us realize why I should avoid having junk food. So these are the things which technology gives you as an advantage.
Sure.
From marketing pitch perspective, from strategies, all that from a return of investment strategies that the sponsor has to make, that definitely helps us
go
a long, long way to plan out your strategies, to plan out your return of investment. So for me, the future in India is definitely technology-based.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because, you know, in sport, sometimes money is also hard to come by, right? And the amount of optimization that technology can do to bridge that gap is also large. I mean, the effects of that are yet to be unfold. But I think what technology will bridge that financial gap also big time. I mean, in terms of scale up, etc.
And just to add, just for the viewers' perspective, La Liga took a conscious decision as a strategic decision to show football live on Facebook as a platform tie-up.
Yes.
And not to go with the mainstream broadcaster.
Absolutely.
A conscious strategy. That's a technology support.
Yes. Absolutely.
And also, and as far as India perspective is, future is data collection. You know, very important. Future is all about data. The more data you have, we are talking about physical fitness, not physical fitness. We are going from arithmetic progression, you can go to geometric progression.
True.
You know? So,
yeah.
One more last part of the question is...
Sir, just before that, I would like to add in technology also. So this is, in my case, it'll help you on proving yourself and then how your progression is as well. So
absolutely.
In the previous marathons that I have run, so there used to be only a timing chip at the start and the end. But now what has happened is they've had a timing chip at almost every 5 kilometers or so. So it helps me know where I fell short or where I had to push myself or where did I push myself too much.
Absolutely.
This is
individual data collection. Again, it's all about data.
Exactly.
How you are able to harness the data for your good. Last point, Rishi, I would come to you. This is, what are the opportunities? Startup, you know, especially technology, short and succinct.
So, startup opportunities, right? I mean, startup opportunities do not come as an idea or a dream or anything of that sort, right? According to me, they come out of your experiences, right? When you experience certain things, when you're working in whatever domain, during your experiences, you actually see the gaps. And startups mainly are born when they see a gap, right? And when you see a gap, you want to bridge it. And that will come out of experiences. They can't come out of, you know, an idea. So SFA was not an idea. Chalo, aisa karte hain, it'll be a great business. It won't happen like that. It's only when you go through the systems and, you know, understand what Absolutely. It takes, where what the challenges are, where the gaps that you can fill is literally the birth of a startup. So that journey, I mean, I worked for 15 years. Before I started this, I was at a job, right? And in my 15 years is where I realized that, okay, something like this can be done because you learn, right?
Absolutely.
Until you don't know what it takes to put it together, you are not going to be able to put it together anyway. So just that one idea is not going to be able to do anything.
True.
You experiment it, you experience it. So yeah, to keep it short, yeah, that's what I feel.
Spot on. Short and succinct. I think more or less loads and loads of questions are there. And since we are constrained for time is vitamin yum here. That is vitamin money. So the takeaway is huge number of points which we discussed today. And this is just, as I told you, it's just a tip of an iceberg. And thank you, gentlemen, for being here. It's a wonderful experience. I learned a lot, quite a lot of jargon, quite a lot of points I learned from you all. And I'm sure it will be beneficial for me in the long run. And thank you, Tanmay. Thank you, Rakesh. Thank you, Rishi. And thank you, Nilesh, for giving opportunity to youngsters and sharing your ideas and inputs. You know, so it will be very valuable for the people, those who are watching. And I hope more and more people take up sport and sport-related activity and make India a proud nation. And also, India a sports tourist destination. You know,
thank you.
You should be there. Thank you so much. Have a lovely day ahead. Okay. And thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you, Skillable.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Srinivasan, for being such a lovely host and a moderator. It was wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, these were the veterans. These are the gurus of the sports and sports administration and fitness. I'm sure we made the most of it. The students, the youth, they're thrilled. I'm sure they're going to implement all that they have heard and listened. And yes, nothing more than working hard. So thank you once again, Mr. Ramji Srinivasan, Mr. Nilesh Kulkarni, Mr. Rishikesh Joshi, Mr. Tanmay, and Mr. Rakesh for being such a wonderful panelist. Thank you once again. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, don't go away. We have something very interesting lined up for you. We have the entertainment session again up for you today and a beautiful set of tracks for tomorrow. And a lovely keynote speaker. Let me introduce you to the keynote speaker for tomorrow and also the tracks that we are going to be having. We're going to be having Ms. Rajita Kulkarni, President Sri Sri University, tomorrow with us as the keynote speaker. And the industrial tracks that we're going to have for you are future skills, gaming, government, international education, also followed up with entertainment sessions. So please don't go away. Stay tuned for tomorrow. Thank you and have a wonderful evening. Thank you, Tanmay.
Thank you.